You played with Big Ben. You played with Peyton Manning. You played with Jimmy Garoppolo. You played with Drew Brees. I mean, which place did you enjoy most over the course of your career, Emmanuel Sanders?
Man, I tell you what, it had to be Denver. And that's because we won the Super Bowl there, right? And playing with Aqib Talib and Von Miller and Chris Harris and all them guys and being able to win it all. Oh, you can't take that for granted. Then those 6 years that I did spend in Denver, it was just some good years. I went to the Pro Bowl out there, won a Super Bowl, just had some really good years. But as I reflect back, truthfully, like, I appreciate everything. I appreciate playing in Pittsburgh with Antonio Brown and Ben Roethlisberger and Le'Veon Bell. And I just appreciate and thank God. It's been a true blessing to play with so many great players and really just sum it up and go on different teams and really see, like, how guys work and taking a piece of their work ethic and adding it to mine, adding certain stuff to mine, because I feel like the more and more that you get out and the more and more that you explore, the more diverse you become and the more culture you become. And so it's been a blessing to play with all those guys, truthfully.
Emmanuel, getting back to the Super Bowl this year, Jimmy Johnson was just on this show, and Coach actually feels the way I do. Tom Brady's the GOAT, no two ways about it. Look at the career accomplishments. But the best he's ever put his eyes on, and he mentioned John Elway and Aaron Rodgers, too. The best he ever put his eyes on is Patrick Mahomes. When you watch Mahomes play, what do you think of him as a quarterback?
Yeah, it's crazy because the best I've seen spin the ball, definitely Aaron Rodgers. And I love watching him play because just the way that he releases the ball and the way that he gets the ball out of his hand. Stephen A., you're right. He's a bad man, but it's hard to say that right now because he got beat, right? But when you watch Patrick Mahomes, and I literally, like, every time I play against this guy, most games I sit on the bench and I'm just watching from the jumbo and trying to watch out of offense. But for some reason, when we're playing against the Chiefs, and I played against him like 3 or 4 times, I find myself just standing up and appreciating what he does, because when I tell you, like, that Patrick Mahomes miracle, it's true. The way that he scrambles outside the pocket, the throws that he makes, like, you know, I was a part of the game where he rolled out of the pocket and, you know, Von is chasing him down and he flicks the ball with his left hand, right? And just, he's been making them plays every time. You know, think about the game we played against him this past year. The throws that he made on the run where literally it's third down, and I'm thinking, all right, we got to stop right here. And he just flushes out of the pocket and just throws a dime. And he just crushes you play after play with his athletic ability. And I remember reading an article on Andy Reid saying that he just has vision. Like, his vision is on a whole nother level. And you see it. When you watch him play, you see it. His vision and the way that he approaches the game is something that I haven't really seen. And I guess it's in comparison to John Elway and the way that he scrambles around, but he's got the big arm to match it as well.
So are you trying to say that Patrick Mahomes is the greatest quarterback that you've ever seen, or that he's better than Aaron Rodgers? Are you ready to say that, or are you not?
He's still young right now, right? And It's crazy how the ebb and flow of this goes. If Patrick Mahomes loses his game, then everybody kind of bags off a little bit, right? That's just how it goes. Well, but again, he got an opportunity to win a Super Bowl back-to-back years. Mm-hmm. And as young as he is, I mean, he's on his way.
I'm just going to pass it off to Max and Molly by saying this. I deeply appreciate it because you and I agree. And I know that you watch me and all of that stuff, but one of my most touching moments that I've ever seen from an NFL football player is when you were addressing an audience one day years ago, and you said, Stephen A. is right. I see what he said about you damn Cowboy fans. He's absolutely right. You know what I'm saying? I remember that, and that touched me. That NFL player finally validated what I've been saying about them sorry, pathetic Dallas Cowboy fans.
Taking a fight with the Cowboys. They know Cowboys here.
So thank you for that. Thank you for that. I just want to say it touched my heart. It touched my heart.
I love you, Stephen. I heard Coach say you scream and holler, man, but you bring the energy to television, man. Hey, I love turning on that too, man, and watching you and Max go at it. I love it.
Thanks a lot, bro. Thank you.
Thank you, brother. We love watching you play. Do you feel like the way I feel watching the Saints team the last year? I was very disappointed for Drew Brees, who I'm a big fan of, because I felt like, damn, Drew, this is the best shot you've had since the last Super Bowl. I thought you guys had the most well-rounded, most balanced team. I think you were a big reason for that. They really needed a number two receiver to go with Michael Thomas, and it was a tie game in the fourth quarter. That's when some of those turnovers occurred. How, as a group, how do you guys regroup from that going into next season?
Max, what you trying to do, man? You trying to bring all these emotions out of me that I kind of let go the past 2 weeks, right? Because we did have a really good team. We had an opportunity to win it all, and we blew it. Like, I can't sit back and make excuses, and I can't blame it on Drew, and I can't blame it on that, right? Because, you know, you sit back and you say, Jared Cook fumbled the ball. Drew threw an interception. It was a plays on defense where we didn't capitalize on interceptions. It was a plays in which, you know, it's a slant route that I wish I could have beat the defender and got open on. It's some stuff that Michael Thomas wished he could have did, and it's a team sport. And we just blew it at the end of the day.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.